Today we start with the last topic of the module 1, which is the time domain analysis of the RL and RC circuit. Now, what is called this time domain analysis? Here, if you want to understand what is called this time domain analysis, then if you just think, in your home a bulb is there. So bulb is not directly powered up from the wall socket, it is controlled by a switch. And if you just press the switch, can the bulb glow on after 1 second or instantly?
Sir, instantly,
sir.
So that means for a resistive load, if we just give the power, instantly it starts working. But two components are there in electrical engineering. Due to these two components, the maximum power transfer theorem, maximum power transfer is not happening instantly. And these two components are called, one is the inductance, another is the capacitance. What is called an inductance? So inductance is nothing a coil, but according to the definition, it's the property of the coil by which the changes of current opposes. So if you want to change the current, then it opposes. And for the capacitor, it not catch the voltage instantly. It will take some time to, if we connect a voltage source across the capacitor, then ultimately the same amount of voltage is stored across the capacitor, but it's not happen instantly. It will take some time. So that means here we will find out that how much time is required and what is the graph of this time current varying or the voltage varying due to these two component. One is inductor, another is the capacitor. 1 minute, please. So sorry for this one. So we will see that how the, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So
how the current is actually varying through the inductor or how the voltage is varying across the capacitor, we will find out the expression and all this kind of thing here. So that's why it is called the time domain analysis, because the current is not grown to its normal value or the final value instantly. It will take some time. And within this time, what is happening actually, we will find out. First, the time domain analysis of the RL circuit. Why it is called RL? Because you see in this sample circuit, one resistance is there, another inductance is also there. So this is the resistance and this one is the inductance. We generally use capital L to denote inductance and capital R for the resistance. And here you see one voltage source is connected across these two series connections. So our resistance and inductance are connected in series and one voltage source is connected across it. And this one is controlled by a switch. So this switch S, it has the two pole. Two pole means it can be thrown to the position one. When the switch is connected to the position one, then you see the voltage source is connected across the series combination of R and L. And when it is connected to position two, then you see the voltage source is not connected across the series combination of R and L. Rather, a short circuit link is connected across the R and L. Clear? Is it clear the function of the switch?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, when the switch is connected to position one, then let's see what happened. So when this is actually the case one, when the switch is connected at position one. Then which one is connected across the series combination? The voltage source. So if we apply the KVL, then you see the voltage source is actually distribute itself among the resistance and the inductance. So that means the voltage across the resistance and the voltage across the inductance, VR and VL respectively, if we just take the summation of these two things, then it's equal to the external voltage source V.
Sir.
Yes.
In the first class of our electrical basic electrical engineering, you said that KVL is not applied for a inductor or capacitor. So why we are applying here this?
No, KVL is not applied to the inductor or capacitor. Yes, okay. But this one is the steady state analysis. Steady state analysis means after some time. In this transient period, this KVL is not applied. Because as I mentioned that, when what happened to if we connect a voltage source across the inductor, then what happened initially when the current want to change its value, then inductor opposite. But after some time, when the current reaches to its final value, then inductor doesn't have any role. Okay, this is the properties of the inductor. It's a good question. So before I start this one, I need to explain this one. Inductor is actually nothing but a coil, but the properties of the coil is that it opposes the flow, it opposes the changes of current. What is the resistance? Resistance is a properties of a conductor by which the current flow opposes. If the current want to flow to the resistance, then it opposes the current flow. But as a inductor, if the current want to change, then what happened? Inductor opposes it. So final position DC, we connect a DC voltage source. So that means the current flow to the inductor is also DC. So after some time when everything is settled down, we call it the steady state position. Then current is not changing. So if the current is not changing, inductor doesn't have any effect on this one. What my point?
In the transient position, when the current is changing,
when the current want to change, because everything is not happen instantly. If we connect a voltage source and one resistance is there, then instantly the current reaches to its steady state value, that is V by R, according to the Ohm's law. But
same as the capacitor, like after some time.
Capacitor is actually oppose the changes of voltage. But after some time, if the voltage is settled down, then capacitor inductance doesn't have any role. That's why generally we are not considering the effect of inductor and capacitor in case of DC. But here we want to know that initially what happened in the transient period. Transient period means very, very small period, generally in the microsecond or in the millisecond. So within this time, what happened? When it is become steady state, means when Ohm's law is applicable to this circuit, then inductor and capacitor doesn't have any effect. Okay. You'll see after the expression.
Okay,
so this voltage is distributed itself among the voltage across the resistance and according to the voltage across the inductance. So VR, V equal to VR plus VL, this expression. Now, we know that according to the Ohm's law, VR, that means the voltage across the resistance is nothing but I into R, where I is the current flowing to the this resistance. And as this is a series thing, so same current is flowing to this inductor also. So we know that voltage across the inductor is L di dt. L is the value of the inductance. And DIDT is the changes of current. So we just break the VR as IR and we just break the VL as LDIDT. Now, if we just, this is equal to V. So if we just divide the equation in both sides by R, it becomes V by R equal to I plus L by R into DIDT. Now, if we just change the side of this DT, then it is coming V by R into DT equal to DI by VR minus I. Okay. Now, so after this one, if we integrate both sides with respect to DT, then we come, it's coming R by L into T equal to log V by R minus I plus K. So K is the integration constant. From the initial condition, we can find the values of the K. What is the initial condition? Initial condition means at t equal to zero, what is the current? In this circuit, at t equal to zero means at the moment when
current is also zero, yes, sir.
Yes,
at current the moment is also
zero. We just throw the switch at the position one. So in that instant, okay. So initial value means at time zero, we just throw the switch at position number one. So instantly, due to the presence of the inductor, current is not able to reach to its steady state value, which is equal to I here. So initially, current is obviously zero because inductor gives a opposition to this flow changes of this value of the current. So at time zero, current is also zero. So this is the initial condition. Now if we put all the values initial condition in that expression, it's coming k equal to minus log v by r. Okay, so substituting the values of k in that expression, it's coming r by l into t log v by r minus I, as it was minus log v by r. Now we are actually replacing the value of k here. Okay, so after taking the common, it's become log v by r minus I divided by v by r. Now if we just change the side, then it's coming v by r minus I equal to v by r e to the power minus r by l t. If we just change this one, if we just take it in the ln side, then it's coming like this. Now here you see I equal to then v by r 1 minus e to the power minus r by l t. Okay, so here you see I equal to become v by r minus 1 minus e to the power r by l t. Now this one, we are actually replacing the value of this by t by tau. So tau is called the time constant of this particular circuit, and the value of tau equal to l by r. So if you just replace the value of tau, it's coming r by minus r by l into t. So that means tau, this is a very important thing, tau, which is called the time constant of the RL circuit, and the value of tau is l by r. Now what is called the time constant? So now at t equal to infinite, this is another condition, final condition. So now at t equal to infinite, what is the meaning of t equal to infinite? Because t equal to zero, everybody can understand. It is
sir, the initial. T equal to infinity means that we have a steady state current.
Sorry. 1 minute. One by one, please. T equal to infinite means?
Means we have achieved a steady state current.
Very good. Next answer. T equal to infinite means when everything becomes steady state. There is no change of the current. Current becomes steady. So it's called the infinite time. Whatever be the after 1 second, if it is called, then t one infinite means it's equal to 1 second. So that means after this time, when everything becomes steady state, there is no change of the current. This time is called the infinite time. Okay. So at t equal to infinite, the current becomes steady state. So if the current is steady state, then what is the value of the current? It simply becomes V by R. So as I mentioned that when everything becomes steady state, there is no influence of the inductance in the circuit. So putting the inductance or deleting the inductance doesn't have any effect. So inductance, there is no inductance in the circuit after the steady state, and simply Ohm's law can be applied in the circuit, and which equal to V by R, because V is the voltage source which is connected in the circuit, R is the resistance. So it's equal to V by R, which is called I zero. What is called I zero? Because this is the final value. Generally in the electrical engineering, we denote the zero as a final value. Sometimes it is the initial value, obviously, but I zero means it's a steady state value of the current. And here you see this V by R is also present here in this expression. So why not to replace this V by R by I zero? So that means final expression of the current equal to I equal to I zero 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. And if you just elaborate this one, it's become I equal to I zero into 1. That means I zero minus I zero into e to the power minus t by tau, as I mentioned here. So this part here, you see, is there any t related to this first term? There are two terms in the expression of I. One is I zero. Second one is the I zero e to the power minus t by tau. So just look at the first term I zero. Is there any t associated with the term?
No, sir.
That means this is a constant current. Whatever be the time, this current is not changing. Okay, so that's why it is called the steady state current. And just come to the second term, which is I zero e to the power minus t by tau. Now, is there any t associated with the term?
Yes, sir.
So obviously, yes, sir. E to the power minus t by tau. Yes. So as the t associated with the term, here you see as the t associated with the term. So this current, this is obviously a current. So this current is actually time varying current, because t is associated with this term. At different value of the t, this gives different value of the current. So this is called the transient current. So transient current means initially changing current is called the transient current. So the final expression of the current is actually the steady, it contains the steady state part as well as the transient part. Now, as I mentioned, this tau is called the time period, which is equal to L by R. Now, what is the definition of that particular time? What is the definition of this particular term? Time constant. the time taken by the current to reach 63.2% of its final value is called the time constant tau. This is the definition of the time constant. The time which is taken by the current to reach 63% of its final value is called the time constant. In this circuit, time constant equal to L by R. Now the proof is that, so if we just put the value of T equal to L by R in that expression, so in this expression, if you just put the value of T equal to L by R, then you see, this is the expression I equal to I zero 1 minus e to the power minus T by tau. Now T equal to tau, so it's become minus 1. If you just calculate this value, ultimately it is coming 0.632 I zero. So that means we can say at T equal to tau, the current expression is 63.2% of its final value. So that's why it is called the time constant. According to the definition, this time constant definition is valid for every RC, RL, all this kind of circuit. So whenever the current reaches 63.2% of its final value, then it is called the time constant. Now the graph. So after the graph, I think everything become very clear to you. This is actually the final current I0. This axis is the current axis. This is the time axis. This axis is the time axis. And finally, what is the value of current? Means after some time, what do you observe? The what current is circulating in the circuit when everything becomes steady?
So V by R.
I naught, sir.
V by R or I naught or I zero, whatever you call. So yes. This is actually the final value of current. We call it the steady state current. But due to the presence of the inductor, the current is not able to reach instantly from the beginning to I zero. It takes some finite time. So here you see. And what is the initial value of the current in that circuit when you just throw the switch at position 1?
Sir, 0.
Zero. So that means you see the current is started from 0. The current is generating from the 0. This is actually the current. This curve is actually the expression of the current in that circuit. So initially started 0. Now it increasing. Because you see in this term, I0 minus something is there. So that means initially this one has the I0 value. So both are 0. But finally, this term is dies down. So ultimately, I become I0. So that means it's increasing in order. So it's increasing, increasing, increasing at this particular time when T equal to become tau, you see, it is equal to 63.2% of the final value I0. So this current, this time is called the time constant, means up to this time is it's called the time constant of this particular circuit. And the expression for the time constant is L by R. Now, finally, it reaches to this one. But one thing is that you never draw this line like this one. You never touch this one. Okay. This is not theoretically possible. So that means at infinite, we can say this current is actually touches this I0, but not in the graph. So in the graph, always put some gap between these two lines. And this is actually the expression of, this is actually the graph of the rise in current in an RL circuit. Rise in current means current is actually rising. The expression is I naught or V by R into 1 minus T by tau. This one is actually the expression of this particular line. And this is called the rise in current. And this is the time domain analysis of the RL circuit. Because we are actually analyzing the current in time domain. Means according to the time, what is actually happening to the current? What is the nature of the current to this particular circuit? We are actually analyzing this one. Okay. So rise in current in RL circuit during transient period. Come to this one. When we just put after, so after steady state, the current is become I0 or the I0 or the V by R. Now we throw the switch S to position number 2. Now the voltage source is cut from the circuit and one short circuit link is placed across the R and L. Okay. Now what happened? If we just connect it to position number 2, then this part doesn't have any effect. This part is cut down from the circuit due to the switch. Now the short circuit link is placed across the R and L. Now what happened?
There will be no potential difference between like these two things. So
look. So I think inductor theke current flow hobe
na
o to energy store kore rakhe.
Good, this is the 100% correct answer.
Okay,
because these two things, inductor and capacitor in the electrical engineering, these two things are able to store the energy. रेजिस्टेंस इज नॉट एबल टू स्टोर द एनर्जी. व्हेन वी पास द करंट थ्रू द रेजिस्टेंस इट कन्वर्ट द एनर्जी टू द हीट एनर्जी. सो द रिवर्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल. फ्रॉम द हीट व्हेन इट इज कूल डाउन द रेजिस्टेंस इज अगेन सप्लाई द करंट टू द सर्किट. दिस थिंग इज नॉट हैपनिंग इन केस ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस. सो इट कन्वर्ट द एनर्जी इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी टू द हीट एनर्जी. But in case of resistance and capacitance, they are actually able to store the electrical energy. In inductance, it stored the energy in case of electromagnetic form, and capacitor stored the energy in case of electrostatic form. So when we placed a short circuit link, then this stored energy across the inductor now released through the capacitance. Okay, then current is actually decaying. So when the switch is at position 2, then we see L di dt plus ri equal to 0 because there is no other voltage sources. Now di by I equal to minus r by L t, we just rearranging which is convenience to do the integration. Then integrate with respect to time t, it's coming log I equal to minus r by L t plus k. Again, this k is the integration constant, and from the condition we can easily find out the value of k. So this value of k determined by applying the initial condition. Here the initial condition is at t equal to 0, I equal to how much? At t equal to 0 means when we just throw the switch from position 1 to position 2. This time is called the initial or the initial value of the time. Then what is the value of current in the circuit?
So 0?
No. It's not zero. It's equal to, as it is written, I, the initial value of current I equal to I zero, which is equal to V by R. Why? Because we are not start our experiment just connecting the position, just connecting the switch at position number 2. Initially, we always start to connect the switch at position number 1, and we keep it position number 1 for a long time so that it can call an infinite time, so that the current through the circuit become steady state, which is equal to I zero. Okay, because you see, after some time the current becomes steady state, so there is no effect of the inductance, so current become I zero. Now when after some time, means after the t equal to infinite, we just throw the switch from position 1 to position 2, so that means this is now become the initial current when you just throw the switch at position number 2. Got it?
Okay, sir.
So that means, sir, initially we are giving the inductor chance to store energy, and when
the
energy,
complete, the full yes, energy. When it's the full complete, energy, then we just then when the inductor is fully charged or fully charged, energy
stored energy, then we just
then we throw the switch at position number 2.
Position number 2.
So that's why it is written that at t equal to 0. T equal to 0 mean not from the initial. T equal to 0 mean when we just throw the switch
to
position number 2. After yes, keep the switch at position number 1 for a long time.
Sir, 1 থেকে 2 তে মানে সুইচটা মানে যখন আমরা দিচ্ছি দেন তখন কি সঙ্গে সঙ্গে কারেন্ট ফ্লো করতে শুরু করবে মানে ইন্ডাক্টর থেকে?
Yeah.
Just immediately.
Yes, yes. Because you see that inductor is storing some energy. Now the inductor becomes the active source of this thing. So this is only the thing which is able to supply the energy to the circuit.
Okay. I am assuming that the magnetic energy theke jokhon electrical energy to convert to kichuta time lage.
No, it's not the thing.
Okay.
So therefore, this just put the values of the initial condition. So log I equal to minus R by L T plus K. Now at t equal to 0, I equal to I 0. So after putting all these things, the value of k coming log I 0. And k equal to log V by R. I 0 means V by R. So substituting the value of k in the above expression, final expression become like this one. Log I equal to minus R by L t plus log V by R. This is the value of k we just derived. Or we can say I equal to V by R e to the power minus R by L t. Or we can say V by R means initial current or the steady state current I0. So it's, we can write also I0 e to the power minus R by L t. And we know that L by R equal to tau or the time constant of the circuit. So we can also write I0 equal to e to the power minus t by tau. So you see three expressions are there for the decaying in current. Or we can say when we put the switch or throw the switch at position number 2, then the decaying of current has three expressions. Why the three expressions are required? Because according to the data given in the numericals in the semester or in the class test or whatever be the exam is, sometime we need to use the equation number 1, sometime we need to use the equation number 2, and sometime we need to use the equation number 3. All the equations are exactly same, but the representation is different. This is equal to V by R, this is equal to I zero, this is equal to T by tau. Okay, so according to the data given, you can use the this equation number 1, 2, or 3. So this is the thing. This is the graphical representation of this thing. This is the first steady state current I zero. Now you see, as there is no external sourcer connected in the circuit, so finally the current reaches zero, because inductor is not able to supply the current for a long time. It can supply for a small time. When the energy is released, then there is no source present in the network and the current becomes zero. So I zero is the initial value of current here, which is equal to V by R. Now the current is actually decaying because inductor releasing the energy through the capacitor, through the resistance. So the current is decaying. And again, at this particular time tau, the I zero, or the current in the circuit, is actually become 36.8% of the final value of current. That's why the time constant is called this one. This one is actually the 100 minus 63.2. It's becoming 36.8%. So in case of decaying of nature, if the current reaches 36.8% of the final value, we call it the tau, or the time constant of the circuit. And in case of means increasing in nature, when the time is, when the current is reaches 63.2%, 68.2% of this 63.2% of the final value, we call it the time constant. So this is the difference between the time constant of decaying current and increasing current. Okay, and the expression is like that. It's equal to I zero e to the power minus t by tau. Again, I mentioned that you should not join these two lines, because ideally or theoretically, this will touches the line or I zero or zero. It becomes zero at time equal to infinite. So in the graph, never show this decaying current which is touches to the zero line. So you may get some numerical based on this formula. So you need to remember these three formulas for the decaying current: V by R e to the minus t. E to the power minus R by L into T, or these two, to do the numerical. Similarly for this one also, you need to remember this formula to do the numerical when the current is actually increasing. Come to this one, the last one, the time domain analysis of the RC circuit. Here you see the inductor is not present, rather one capacitor is present in the same circuit. The circuit is connected to the external voltage source V through a switch when it is connected to position 1, and one short circuit link is placed across the series combination of R and C when the switch is connected at position number 2. Now when the switch is connected to position number 1, we call it the capacitor charging, because you see one voltage source is connected across the capacitor. So by nature, the capacitor will charge at voltage V automatically, and it will take some time. So that means when the capacitor is charged at voltage V, then what will be the current in the circuit? Because at t equal to infinite, definitely the capacitor is charged to that same voltage V. Then what will be the current in the circuit?
So zero.
Zero, because in both the side, there are the same potential is applied. So there is no potential drop in the circuit. So current is not able to flow in the circuit. But this is happened when we connect the switch at position number 1 for a long time. But means below this time, we call it the capacitor is actually charging. And when the capacitor charge at V, we call it capacitor is fully charged. And when the capacitor is fully charged, there is no current flowing in the circuit. Okay. Again, when we throw the switch at position number 2, we call it the capacitor discharging, because as there is no external energy sources connected in the circuit, so this is become only one external, this is become the only one active sources in the network. So capacitor is actually become a voltage source. Then it start discharging through the resistance, and it is not able to allow the supply the current infinite time. So after some time, the current is again become zero. So this is called the capacitor discharging. So first we understand what is called the capacitor charging. So when the switch is at position 1, the external value, external voltage source V equal to Ri plus Vc. Vc is the voltage across the capacitor, and R into I is the voltage across the capacitor, or you can say the Vr. Now we know that capacitor expression is C equal to Q by Vc. Q is the charge stored in the capacitor, Vc is the voltage across the capacitor. Now, Q equal to CVc, and we know what is called Q, what is the charge? Charge is nothing but the accumulation of current. So if we just take the summation of the currents, then we can get the charge stored in the capacitor. So that's why the summation, overall summation or integration is the same thing. So integration, Q means integration, IdT. IdT equal to CV, CVC, or I equal to C dV, C dT. So this is the current through the capacitor, I equal to C, that means the capacitor value, into DVC dT. That means the derivation of the voltage across the capacitor with time. Now, again, we need to write all these things. V equal to Ri plus Vc. Now, just replace the value of I in that expression. So it's coming R into C into DVC dT plus Vc. So V minus Vc equal to RC DVC dT, or DT by RC equal to this one. And integrating both sides, we are actually getting T by RC ln V minus Vc plus K. Again, from the initial condition, we need to find out the value of K, then the expression will complete. So to find out the value of K, we put the initial condition at time t equal to 0, the voltage across the capacitor Vc equal to 0. So obviously, we assume that the capacitor is fully discharged before our experiment, means before we connect the switch at position number 1. So when the switch is connected to position number 1, at that instant, there is no current, there is no charge stored in the capacitor. So the voltage across the capacitor is obviously zero. So this is the initial condition. And if you just put the initial condition in that expression, ultimately it is coming K equal to ln V. So T by RC, ln V minus Vc plus ln V, or after rearranging this thing, it ultimately coming Vc equal to V 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. And now the difference is that tau equal to RC. So in case of capacitive circuit or the resistance capacitance combination, the time constant definition will be definitely same, but the expression is RC initially, which was L by R in case of RL circuit. But in case of RC circuit, the time constant is R into C. And this is the expression for voltage across the capacitor. So you see, initially there is no voltage across the capacitor, but finally it reaches to V. When T become infinite, it reaches to V. Now in this side, the expression for current, same, V equal to Ri plus Vc, or I equal to V by R minus V by R, Vc by R. And after doing this Vc, we have an expression of this Vc. So just replace the Vc from that equation to that expression, it will coming this way, and ultimately we are getting I, which is equal to I0 e to the power minus t by tau. So now this is actually the difference between the RL circuit and RC circuit. In case of RL circuit, when we throw the switch at position number 1, then the current is increasing, and finally the current reaches to the I0 value. But in case of RC circuit, when we throw the switch at position number 1, then what happened? Current is actually, initially the current has a very high value, I0, but ultimately the current is become zero because the capacitor is fully charged to V. Okay. We have the graph obviously. So after this slide, we show you the graph. So when the switch is at position number 2, then it is called the capacitor discharging. Then the capacitor will discharge through this particular resistance. It will supply current through this thing for a few times. So I equal to dQ dt or C dVc dt. Thus, C dV dt equal to minus Vc by R. Okay. Why it is negative? Why put the negative sign? Because we put the negative sign, because whatever be the direction of current, when we throw the switch at position number 1, then the current is actually flowing in this direction. But now, when we throw the switch at position number 2, then current is flowing in the opposite direction. Because this one is become a voltage source now, of a fully voltage, fully charged V. So that means it throw the current or it supply the current in the opposite direction. That's why to mention this opposite, we put in negative sign. Or if you just do the, yes.
Inductor khetro ki opposite hoye jay direction ta current.
Yeah, inductor khetro obviously opposite hoye jay, but in case of inductor, we are actually considering the voltage. That's why you are not putting the negative sign. But here you see, as we just doing the our experiment, doing our this expression using the current, then we must put a negative sign. So ultimately, after integrating all these things, it's coming minus ln Vc equal to T by RC plus K. Now we need to put the initial condition. Initial condition means when we just put the switch at position number 2, that is become the initial condition, not from the beginning. So at t equal to 0 means when we just throw the switch at position number 2, Vc, that means the voltage across the capacitor, equal to V, because the capacitor is fully charged to the external voltage source V. So after replacing this one, we are getting this expression I, which is equal to minus Vc by R, equal to minus V by R e to the power t RC, or this one minus I zero e to the power minus t by RC, or you can say minus t by tau. Again, three expressions are there. Whatever is required to solve the numericals, you can use that one. Minus V by R e to the power minus t by RC, minus I zero e to the power minus t by RC, and the third one is not written. Third one is minus I zero e to the power minus t by tau. Tau is the time constant, and the expression of the time constant in a RC circuit is R into C. So here you see the graph. The graph is looks like a complicated, but it's easy to understand. So this is the transient current I and capacitor voltage Vc in RC circuit. Now here you see this one. This one is actually the capacitor charging, means when we throw the switch at position number 1. Initially there is no voltage across the capacitor. Capacitor is fully discharged initially. So this initial, this thing is actually when we just put the switch at position number 1. So final value is V. Capacitor is charging, so its voltage is increasing. At this time, when the capacitor voltage is reaches 63.2% of the final value of voltage V, we call it the time constant RC. That's why it is showing here tau equal to RC. Then at infinite time, we can say the capacitor voltage will reach to the final value of voltage V. Okay, this is about the voltage. So obviously, if the voltage is increasing, definitely the current is decreasing. So initial current is I zero V by R, but as the capacitor is growing its charge, so it actually opposes the current flowing in the circuit. So current is decreasing from the final initial value I zero, and at time t equal to this one, t equal to RC, the value of the circuit current reaches 36.8% of the initial value I zero. So we call it the time constant. At t equal to infinite time, the current will reaches to zero. So that is the growing of voltage and decaying in current in case of capacitor charging, or we can say when we put the switch in the position number 1. Second figure, decay of voltage across charged capacitor and circuit current. Now the capacitor is fully charged because we put the switch at position number 1 for a long time. Now we just throw the switch at position number 2, so capacitor will discharge through the resistance, and in that time you see the this one is actually started from minus I zero. Why the minus sign? Because as I mentioned that the capacitor throw the current in the opposite direction. So initially the capacitor voltage is V, then it start decreasing. This is the expression. And at t equal to infinite time, it will reaches to zero. And this one is also same, I zero, it will start from I zero, and finally it reaches to zero, obviously. And this minus sign is because the current is opposite compared to position number 1 when the capacitor is discharged. And that is the definition of the time constant.
Sir, direction of current change can only.
Okay.
It is in a setup.
1 minute. So here you see, when we just connect the switch at position number 1, then the capacitor is charging. Capacitor charging means after some time the capacitor working as a battery. So battery, DC battery means obviously it has a polarity. So this side should be positive, this side should be negative. Okay, because if current is through, entering through this side, so this side become positive, this side become negative. Now, this is happened when the current is flowing through this one due to this external voltage source V. And finally, there is no current, because capacitor is fully charged to V potential, and you see there is also a V potential. So if you just apply the KVL, you see the VV is cancelled out, so V minus V is zero. So that's why there is no current. Capacitor become fully charged. Now, if we just show the switch at position number two, this is cut from the circuit. This external voltage source is cut from the circuit. Now, only one voltage source is there, which is this capacitor, and which has a potential. Now, you see, this is the potential. This is the polarity of the capacitor terminal. So, it now allow the current to supply in the circuit in this direction. So, that's why this direction and this direction are completely opposite. So, we just put a negative side, negative sign to illustrate this one. That's why here you see the current is starting from the negative. Current never become negative. Current has a finite value, but negative means it's actually mentioning its polarity. Okay. So here in this last topic, what are the things you required? You need to required to solve the objective. That means what is the value of time constant in RC circuit? What is the value of time constant in RL circuit? What is the expression? What is the definition of the time constant? And this formula. Here you need to know four formulas. One is this one. When the capacitor is charging, then what is the current? So this is actually the current. This one is actually the expression of current, this one. So when the inductor is storing the energy, this is the expression of current. When the current is decaying, then this is the expression. This is the expression. And in case of RC circuit, the voltage across the capacitor, you need to remember this formula also. Okay. Any queries related to this particular chapter, this particular topic? Okay. So this is called the time domain analysis of the RL circuit and RC circuit. So with this, we completed the first module. Now we go for the second module. Now it is 2:30. So at 2:45, we again come back and we start with the module two.
Okay, sir.
Is there any
other? Sir, inductor er khetre, mane inductor ta mane DC khetre work kore na AC khetre?
Inductor appears it presents all the time in case of AC, because in AC inductor the current is changes every time. Okay. But in case of DC, initially when you just switch it on for a very few time, the current is not able to reaches to its final steady state value instantly due to the presence of the inductor or capacitor. So in that time, what is happening, we call it the transient time. And in this time, the appearance of the inductor or capacitor is present. But when after some time, when it is everything becomes steady state, then there is no presence of the inductor as well as in the capacitor. That is the time domain analysis based on DC.
Okay.
In your third semester, you will study one circuit. Sarvajit sir will take the circuits, circuit theory. So in the circuit theory, then again, you need to draw all this kind of thing with respect to AC. Then the same circuit will be there, but now we connect it in the AC. And let's see what will happen in that time. The behavior of the inductor, the capacitor, the current, all these things. So that is called the AC analysis.
Okay.
Now,
okay,
but sir, this one is the time domain analysis of the DC networks.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so is there any student present who has not attended, or other student please leave and you must join at 2:45, okay?
Sir, 28.
28, somebody said?
Sir, 17.
17.
Sir, chilam, sir.
Okay, no problem. Anybody is there? Roll number 1, roll number 9, roll number 18, 19. And roll number, this is Sorosis.
So 17 days, and
yeah, 17.
Sir, 28.
20 is present already. Okay, so thank you very much for attending the class. We'll meet again at 2:45.
Okay, sir.